Okay, so in the last units, you first saw how we can slice and dice the dot product. We then showed you an algorithm that took advantage of slicing and dicing, and we then translated that algorithm into code. Then we went back and we looked at how to slice and dice axpy, and then we showed you an algorithm that uses slicing and dicing to express the algorithm. And this brings us to the point where we can now talk about how to implement that algorithm. So the way we're going to do that is we're going to open up the next IPython notebook. This is 1.6.6. And for the most part, I'm just going to let you read this. It goes through, it sets up a vector, make sure that you execute the boxes. We have a vector x and y and alpha. And then we have a simple routine for implementing the axpy that we coded before. We can test that and we get the right answer. And then it starts discussing how to implement the axpy using this Flame API, FLAMEPy API. So what I'm going to do is I'm going to give you a chance to look at the notebook. I'm going to let you look at the algorithm. And then I'm going to let you try on your own how to translate that using the Spark web page. And then once you're done, continue this video and I'll walk you through it. I'm back. So what we need to do is we need to go to the Spark web page. Okay, so now we're at the Spark web page. And what I'm going to do is I'm going to move it over here. And I was clever enough to go ahead and put the algorithm right there so that as we fill out the menu, we can see what we need to do. First thing we need to do is, well, let's make this a little larger. There. First thing we need to do is name this routine. So we'll call it an axpy. Let's just leave this alone and make it an unblocked algorithm. We're not going to give it a variant number. And then we need to decide how many operands there are. Well, there's alpha, x, and y. So I'll choose three operands. And the first one is going to be alpha, which is a scalar. And it's just input. Then I need vector x, which is a vector. And we'll march through it from top to bottom. That's important to look at right here. And it's just input. And then we need vector y, which is a vector, and we march through it from top to bottom, and it's both input and output, because vector x is going to be overwritten by alpha x plus y. The output we're going to choose is FlamePy. I'll put in my name as the author. And then on the right here, it created the algorithm. I'll highlight this, copy it, and now we're ready to go back to the Python notebook. Now, the one thing I forgot to do is to create a copy before I start making changes. So let's do that quickly. Here we have our notebook. Let's make this a little bigger. We'll go down to the box where we were supposed to enter this. That's right here. I'll highlight this. I'll enter the routine. Let's get rid of these spaces. And bingo, I now have a code skeleton. And all I need to do is now put this again next to my algorithm and recognize that I just need to update, put in some update lines. And the update lines that we're going to do the update lines are that psi 1 needs to be updated by alpha times chi 1 plus psi 1. Okay, now I need to make sure I execute all of the boxes. So let's make sure that I say run all above. And then I'll run this box itself. And then I have a little test, piece of test code right here. And I will execute that, and lo and behold, I get the right answer the first time. Hopefully you did as well. Okay, so hopefully you're getting a little bit hang of how to do this. And This will hopefully help you write code in a way that closely mirrors the algorithms. Why did we present the algorithms this way? Well, for the sake of this course, I really want you to get used to thinking of vectors in terms of subvectors, and the way we present the algorithms here, as well as the way we code, does exactly that for you.